Political brawling between the state and federal governments appears to have reached a new low as Barry O'Farrell and Julia Gillard bicker over taking money away from the poor and vulnerable and whether the carbon tax is to blame. Josh Murphy takes a look from both angles.
Life in public housing for George Navia is no easy run. He allows himself $20 a day to live.
You've got to budget yourself big time.
That budget will get much tighter next March when the O'Farrell government increases his rent, all because he's getting carbon tax compensation payments from Canberra.
Julia is giving us with one hand, okay, and Barry is taking us from the other one.
And the PM is on his side. Carbon tax compensation for single pensioners will be up to $338. The rent rise will claim a third of it.
Barry O'Farrell has decided to line his own pockets at the expense of people in public housing.
Well, no, we're not. The fact is that we're passing on the costs that have been imposed upon the state government by Labor's carbon tax.
Defending his defiant colleague, Prue Goward, who dropped the announcement late yesterday.
Oh, yes! Oh, yes!
Yesterday, the minister justified the hike, claiming the carbon tax would cost the government more to build new social housing units to the tune of $50 million over the next 4 years.
This is a despicable act. It is completely unjustified.
No apologies from the Premier, but politics.
Stop introducing the carbon tax.
George just wants him or the PM to spend a week at his place, in his shoes, living on the pension.
How you feel, basically, because they don't know, you know.
Josh Murphy, 10 News.